military operation to topple Saddam Hussein is now underway.
We're seeing history unfold.
It's weapons of mass destruction.
Allahu Akbar!
And now it's full. A cheer goes around the square.
Journey there, I think we were all quite quiet, and our translator just sort of kept whistling and just saying, "Fallujah." We drove straight to the school, and there was already a crowd. And there was this helicopter buzzing around. I don't know if you've ever heard an Apache helicopter, but they've got a really distinct sound, and they just sound evil. The crowd had swelled and people were getting more agitated. They said, "We're going to march to the hospital." But to go to the hospital, they needed to turn left. Instead of turning left, they turned right towards the Ba'ath Party headquarters, which is where the Americans had withdrawn to. Things were starting to get a bit tense. They had someone to vent their anger at because they had American troops in this building. They were getting a lot louder. Out of nowhere, this convoy just started to drive straight up the road. Demonstrators were on. I saw some people throwing sandals, and they do that because that's the ultimate insult.
We want to talk about photos that can change the world or change people's thinking. And you think of some of the ones over the years, there's some of the famous ones. I remember Muhammad Ali boxing underwater. There's also the iconic shot of that young Japanese girl in Hiroshima fleeing away as the bomb's going off. It's just terrible images. And Sydney has its own. On January 31, 1999, the Sun Herald published a shocking image of a 15-year-old boy shooting up in a syringe-littered gutter at taxpayer-funded mobile exchange in Caroline Lane in Redfern. We want to talk to the man who actually took that photo. He's a freelance photographer. His name's Julian Andrews. And Julian, welcome to the Grill Team.
As his vehicle came through, I just followed it. And then when it passed, you know, you could see that there were people that were lying flat on the ground, trying to lie flat next to a curb to get some kind of protection. I saw this guy dying in front of my eyes. I saw this guy kind of half standing up with his head, top of his head missing, and it wasn't a very pleasant thing to see. But as he fell down, because it was a boiling hot day, and as the blood poured out of his head and hit this boiling hot road, there was this sickly, sweet smell of his blood. And that is something I've never been able to sort of get rid of. If I think about that day and that incident, that smell instantaneously, like it's there, I can smell it.